Hi, I'm Matt Wagner, writer, artist, creator of Mage, and I'm going to draw Kevin Matchstick, my comic book alter ego and the main character of Mage. Each of the first two series was 400 plus pages of story art. Character keeps evolving, and an evolving personality too. He grows up. That's the whole thing about Mage, is it's about growing up whether you want to or not. I don't want any ideas I come up with to grow stale as the years go by. I don't want to feel like if my viewpoint and opinion on the character and my life changes, I don't want to be stuck with something I had decided about the character years before. I find I'm not doing much in the way of even character designs or anything. I do some scribbles on a page and they're kind of what I want it not to be. I'll screw around with some creature designs or stuff like that and I go, nah, not like that, not like that. Okay, now what I'm doing. And I go back to the page and just draw it right on the page. Because the last trilogy came out in the late 90s, and here we are in 2017, and in that time, I had the time to breed and raise my own colorist, because my son is coloring this, and he's doing a tremendous job. His name's Brennan Wagner. Even on the page, I generally don't pencil more than what you see here for myself, and I'll do what people in the industry would call full pencils, the biggest reason being that I'm inking it myself. Same way I don't want to tie myself down with preconceptions in the story, I want to keep every stage of my drawing of this fresh, so the ink isn't just something to trace the pencils with. The ink is its own tool, and the ink has its own personality, and so the ink should be given as much chance to kind of speak for itself as the pencils did. I don't tend to delineate the lighting, the shading. I don't tend to, as they say in the industry, spot my blacks. In the pencil stage, I do that with the inks. First couple times within the new series here, it took a little while to get used to drawing the shape of my head, because, you know, of course, everybody's head is unique and distinctive. I'm drawing with Sharpies here mainly because I'm on camera, and they make a much fatter line that's easier to see in this fashion. Generally at home, I use a series of artist pens that are made by Faber-Castell. They're called Pitt Artist's Pens, and they come in a variety of nibs. And for those of your viewers that aren't familiar with Mage, this is my literary alter ego. Basically what I'm doing is taking the aspects of my own life and mythologizing them. And the way that came about, when I was just a fledgling, I had an idea to do a story about the return of King Arthur in modern day. And right around that time, as I was starting to develop, and I will readily admit I was nowhere near skilled enough to pull off what I was hoping to do, but DC Comics announced they were going to do Camelot 3000. And I was like, well, there goes that idea. And besides that, Brian Boland guy draws a little bit better than I do. And then it came out, and it just didn't do anything for me. I mean, it was certainly beautiful. It was extremely professional in all regards. And I was just like, I don't know any of these characters. I don't know any guys that in modern day that wear full armor and swords and such. I know a bunch of guys in t-shirts running around the alleys in the city. So I decided maybe there's a different way to do this. Take a myth and personalize it. You have to make it your own. And of course, it's an allegory. You know, I don't really think I run into ogres and battle them with magic instruments, but it's a metaphor for the insurmountable challenges that life seems to throw at all of us, you know? Don't we all fight our own dragons and giants, like, almost every day? So again, for viewers that aren't quite familiar with the storyline, this character discovers that he is the reincarnation of Arthur Pendragon. And as a result, he can control the mystic weapon Excalibur, and in the first several series, that's a baseball bat. And then eventually he discovers that it never had to be a baseball bat. That was a limiting way of looking at things. And so by the time this series comes about, he can spark up any object he touches with the power of Excalibur. So I'm Matt Wagner. This is my comic book alter ego, Kevin Matchstick, hero of the Mage trilogy from Image Comics.